Okay, so we start, huh? Okay, so you can share the link to your friend also halfway that want to join. Boleh kongsi link juga. Okay. Okay guys, can you all see my screen? Coba komen. Can you all see the screen clearly? Boleh nampak screen tak guys? Coba komen. Kena? Okay. So now guys, today we will start on the last part of normal distribution. Kita akan mula bahagian terakhir tabuan kebarangkalian. Okay? So guys, we will start with question 6. Okay, kita akan mula dengan soalan nombor 6. Okay. So guys, number 6. All the question here is normal. Okay, setiap soalan adalah tabuan normal. Itu adalah guarantee. Okay, so now okay, so kita analisis soalan lah. Okay, so they tell you that variable X is normally distributed. Okay, dia bertabuan secara normal dengan mean 0.75. Okay, mean is 0.75. Okay guys, mean dalam tabuan normal, kita bagi simbol apa biasanya? What is the symbol for mean? Can you all tell me? Kita ada satu simbol untuk mean. Siapa tahu? Anyone? Yes. Guys, the symbol we call it as mu. Okay, saat kalau boleh saya cuba tulis. Okay, so dia akan nampak macam ni guys. Okay, something like this. This is your symbol for mean. Okay? So, bila nampak mean dalam tabuan normal, itu adalah simbol dia. Okay, that is the symbol. Alright. Okay, so kita pergi lagi. Okay, so mean, lepas tu mereka bagi tahu sisian PRY, the standard deviation is equal to sigma. Okay, so now, mereka bagi nilai ni. Okay, they give you this information. So, they suruh kamu cari nilai sigma. Okay, you have to find the standard deviation. Kamu kena cari sisian PRY. Okay guys, so now, boleh saya tahu nilai ni 0.69, 0.69, what does it represent? Adakah dia mewakili skor X atau skor Z? 0.69, the 0.69 value. Is it the X score or Z score? Which one? Yes. Okay, it is going to be your X score. Okay, so mengapa skor X? Sebab kamu boleh lihatlah ketaksamaan dia. Okay guys, can you see the inequality sign is X. So maksudnya 0.69 ni juga adalah X. Both of it is X value, skor X. Okay, so now, apa langkah sekarang yang kamu kena buat guys? Biasanya dalam tabuan normal. Usually in normal distribution, if you have skor X, what is your next step? May I know? Yes. Okay, kamu kena, yes, change to score Z. Correct. Okay, kamu kena tukar kepada score Z, guys. Okay, guys, may I know what is the formula for Z score and X score? Apa rumus yang menghubungkan score X dan score Z? Cuba type. Anyone? The formula. Apa rumus yang menghubungkan score X dan score Z? What is the formula that you are connecting over here between X and Z? Anyone? Come on. Yes, very good. Okay, guys, the formula is going to be Z equal to X minus mean over sigma. Okay, so Z is equal to X minus mean divided by sigma. Okay guys, do you all still remember this formula? Masih ingat kan rumus ni? Ini adalah rumus yang kita akan guna nanti. We will use this formula one. Okay, so guys, may I know? Okay. Kawasan belore kamu sekarang di sebelah kanan atau di sebelah kiri? Where is your shaded region now guys? Left or right? Based on the inequality sign. Yes, it's to the right guys. Okay, kawasan belore adalah ke arah kanan. Okay, how to know is to the right? You just look at the symbol. Okay, lihat simbol saja. Okay, so can you see the symbol is to the right? Okay, dia adalah ke kanan. Okay, so the symbol, the shaded region is to the right. Okay, so now, okay, so first step, kita kena selalu check dua benda, guys, dalam tabuan normal. Always two things. First thing, kebarangkalian dia, nilai dia kena lebih kurang dari 0.5. Itu adalah first step. Okay, you must check and see the value over here. This one over here, is it less than 0.5 or not, guys? May I know? Adakah nilai ni kurang dari 0.5? No. Okay, so what do we do, guys? Apa kita akan buat if the value is greater than 0.5? Kalau nilai dia lebih besar dari 0.5. Yes. Yes, correct. Okay, you're going to use 1 minus, guys. Kamu akan guna satu tolak jawapan yang ni. Okay? So, tekan calculator sajalah. Okay, so 1 minus 0.5178. You have answer is 0.4822, guys. Ini adalah jawapan dia. Okay, selepas tolak. So, means that when you use 1 minus, bila guna simbol satu tolak, okay, kamu akan dapat macam ni. Satu tolak probability Z lebih kurang. Selalu ingat, guys. Bila guna satu tolak, kena tukar simbol. You must switch the sign. Okay? So, lepas tu 0.69, 0.69. Guys, sorry if my writing not so good. Huh? Kalau tulisan saya tak sangat bagus. Sebab tak sangat biasa guna laptop untuk ajar. Biasanya guna tablet. Sebab sekarang saya tak charge tablet. Okay, bahagi dengan sigma. Okay? So equal to 0.5178. Okay guys, boleh? So this is your equation right now. Ini adalah persamaan kamu. So do you all understand, guys? Boleh faham? Can you get this step? Yes or no? Boleh dapat tak, guys? Okay, boleh ya? Okay, so yes. Okay, so now guys, kamu akan pindah satu ni lah. Okay, you shift the one to the right hand side. Pindah kat sini. Okay, so guys, bila pindah satu kat sini kan, adakah kita perlu tukar simbol ni tak? Do we need to change the inequality sign? Yes or no? Okay, very good. No need, guys. Okay, tak perlu tukar simbol ketaksamaan. Okay, you just maintain only. Okay? So, sekarang guys, kamu akan dapat nilai kebarangkalian dia. Okay, so boleh lihat kat sini. Okay, so kamu akan dapat macam ni. Okay. Kat sini guys, mereka tak ubah kebarangkalian. Okay, they never change the probability. Okay, ini pun boleh tapi sikit susah lah. Bila kamu baca nilai, kamu kena tambah negatif dengan sendiri. Itu konsep dia, guys. Kalau kamu tak ubah kebarangkalian kat sini lebih kurang dari 0.5, if you don't change the probability less than 0.5, you must add negative to the Z score yang kamu baca dari jadual tu. Okay? Step yang ni kepada yang ni, kamu baca jadual. Okay, read the table. Okay, kamu kena guna jadual. Okay, guys, bila saya ajar kamu lebih bagus ada jadual di tepi kamu. Lebih senang. Okay, better have your normal table. Okay, yang diberi tu semua nilai, skor Z dan kebarangkalian. Okay, so kalau kamu baca nilai ni, sepatutnya dapat yang ni lah. You should get this value. So, anyone here got problem or not? How to read the normal table. Siapa ada masalah? Tak boleh baca jadual normal tu. Anyone who don't know how to read the normal table still? Kalau ada, cuba komen. If got anyone still don't know how to read the normal table. Anyone? Ada tak? Is there anyone here don't know how to read? Ada sesiapa yang tak tahu tak macam mana nak baca jadual normal? Yes or no? Me. Okay, so very simple. Okay, let me try to find. Okay, chat sana guys. Saya cuba Google bagi kamu. Okay, saya tunjuk contoh lah dari soalan tu. Okay guys, so you can see over here. Wait, Okay, so can you see guys the table? Ini adalah apa yang diberi dalam SPM kamu. Betul? This is the one that is given in your SPM. Okay, so now kamu refer balik soalan ni guys. Okay, 0.5178. Okay, so kami baca dulu. Okay, so 0.5178. Okay, so 0.51. Okay, so kamu nampak nilai dia 0.3085. Okay, so 0.3050, 0.51. Okay, and then 7. Okay, 0.518 lah. Okay, kamu boleh round off guys. You can round off to 0.518. Okay, sebab Z-score hanya boleh baca maksimum 3.4. Okay, 3 decimal place maksimum. Okay, so 0.518. Okay, so you take 0.3050. Okay, so kamu cari nilai 8. Okay, so nilai 8 kamu ada 27. Betul? 27. So guys, 27 ni kamu tambah atau tolak? Do you plus or minus? May I know? Okay, very good. The answer is minus guys. Kamu kena tolak. Okay, always remember dari dalam bila kamu guna jadual ni, kamu kena selalu tolak. Okay, always minus 1. Okay, so you just take 0.3050 minus 0.0027. Okay, so kamu akan dapat jawapan dia. Okay, you will get the answer. Okay, so over here, nilai dia akan sedikit berbeza. The value is different. Okay, because the probability is not less than 0.5. Do you all see it guys? Always remember the condition first step, probability kena lebih kurang dari 0.5. Okay, so I will advise you, don't do this step lah. Jangan buat macam ni. Okay, selalu buat yang biasa punya. Okay. Wait lah guys. Sorry. Guys, saya silap terangkan. This one is probability. Am I right guys? Okay. Yang ni kebarangkalian bukan score Z. Sorry. Saya tersalah faham. I mistaken tadi. Okay, this one is probability. So you refer the table inside here guys. Kamu kena lihat mana nilai 0.5178. Tak ada. Betul? 0.5178 tak ada. So, maksudnya kamu guna satu tolak 0.5178. So, kamu dapat 0.4822. Okay? So, 0.4822 akan ada nilai. So, guys, kamu akan pilih 4840 atau 4801. Mana satu? Kalau nilai dia 4822. Hello Angela, welcome. So which one guys? Do you choose the 40 or 01? Which one? Yes, very good. Always take the larger value guys. Ambil nilai yang lebih besar. Alright? Jangan ambil yang lebih kecil. Okay, so you will get 0.04. Okay, so now guys, 0.4840. Macam mana saya boleh jadi ni 0.4822? Saya kena tolak berapa guys? How many I must minus? May I know? Yes, 18 guys. Okay, so kamu pergi ke sini. Okay guys, so 18. Tak ada nombor 18 guys kat sini. Don't have number 18. So which one do I choose? Saya akan pilih yang mana? 16 atau 20? Which one? What do you all think? Which one should I choose as my third decimal place? Titik perpuluhan ketiga. Saya perlu pilih 16 atau 20. Okay, so actually right, the answer is both also can. Dua-dua pun boleh. Okay, because dia kat tengah-tengah. Am I right? 18 kat tengah-tengah. Antara 16 dan 20. Betul? It's between 16 and 20. So means that you can either write 0.044 or you can also write 0.045. Boleh faham tak guys? Dua-dua ni pun boleh. Okay, so that's why you can see the answer they write. They choose one lah. Mereka pilih satu. 0.045. Boleh faham tak guys? Cara baca jadual. Do you all understand now? Clear? How to read the table? So, yang ni kalau 4 pun, let's say this one is 4 lah guys. It won't make much difference. tak akan bawa beza sangat banyak pun pada nilai yang ni. Okay, it won't affect very much. Okay, do you all understand? Boleh dapat? Mungkin kalau ubah pun, ubah yang ni sahaja. Okay, it will only change the last decimal place. Akan ubah yang terakhir sahaja. Okay, so one or two guys. Satu maksudnya faham, dua maksudnya tak faham. One mean understand, two mean don't understand. So kamu cuba type. Okay, one ah. Okay, very good. Okay, so guys. Okay, so kita proceed lah. So apa-apa soalan setakat ni guys? Any question on this soalan? Ada apa-apa nak tanya saya yang tak clear lagi tentang proses selesaikan? Okay, so mungkin setengah orang tak faham macam mana pergi macam ni. Some of you don't understand how you go from here to here. Am I right? Okay, so kamu boleh tulis langkah extra. You can write an extra step, which is this one guys, yang saya tunjuk tadi. Okay, kamu boleh tulis langkah ni. Okay, sebagai tambahan, this thing, this whole thing. Okay guys, boleh? Kamu boleh tunjuk yang ni juga, kat sini. Antara yang ni, okay, in between. Okay, clear guys? Supaya kamu lebih faham lah apa yang kamu buat, you understand better. Okay, so next question. Okay, so number 7 guys, soalan ketujuh. Okay, so may I know? They ask you to find the mean. Okay, the mu value, which is the mean. So, 16 guys, apa maksud 16 tu yang kamu nampak? What is the meaning of number 16? May I know? What does it represent? No, guys, normal guys. Tabuan normal. 16 tu mewakili apa? What does it represent? Yes, guys. 16 represent the variance. Okay, so maksudnya guys, sisian piawai kita kat sini berapa? What is our standard deviation value? Yes. Okay. Sisian piawai akan jadi 4. Okay, our standard deviation is 4 because variance equal to 16. Okay. So now we can solve the question. Boleh selesaikan. Okay guys. So now always the first step, remember convert x score to z score. Okay? Tukar dari score x ke score z. Okay, mungkin kamu tanya saya, mana score X kat sini? Kat sini mereka tulis Y. Sama sahaja. It's exactly the same. Whether they put X, Y ataupun B, B pun adalah score X. Okay, huruf selain Z adalah score Z. Any other letter you see besides Z, it is referred to score X. Okay, do you all get it? So they can put any letter they like. Tak kira apa-apa. Alpha pun boleh. Kalau mereka letak simbol alpha pun maksudnya score X. Okay, if they put alpha symbol, it also means score X. Okay, so now, may I know, kamu akan guna kaedah apa kat sini untuk selesaikan? What method? First step, kamu selalu tengok di sebelah kanan. Look on the right. The probability value. It is greater than 0.5. Am I right? Dia lebih besar dari 0.5. Yes. So you're going to use the 1 minus method. Okay, kamu guna kaedah satu tolak. So guys, when we use 1 minus, what must I change in my equation? Saya kena ubah apa bila guna kaedah satu tolak? What is the symbol I must change? Anyone? Kena tukar symbol apa? Which one? What do you all think? Hello guys. Yes. No. Not negative. Bukan negative. Try again. Selain simbol negative. Other than the negative symbol, what must you change? This one guys. Always remember. Yes. Okay, you must change this symbol guys. Kena tukar simbol ni. Bukan Z. Kamu kena tukar simbol lebih besar. Bila guna kaedah satu tolak 0.7321. Okay, we always must change from greater than, you change to less than. Okay, kamu kena opposite, bertentangan. Alright, so selalu ingat yang tu. Tak perlu tambah negatif bila guna satu tolak. Okay, when you use 1 minus, no need to add negative sign to score Z. Okay, kamu kekal sahaja nilai score Z. Just maintain. If negative score Z, kamu maintain negative. Kalau positive score Z, kamu maintain positive. bila guna kaedah satu tolak nilai kat sebelah kanan persamaan. Okay? So, yeah. Then, kamu boleh selesaikanlah. So, jawapan, the answer will look something like this. Okay, so boleh nampak guys? Can you all see it? So, number 7, you will get this answer. Okay, kamu akan dapat macam ni. Alright? So, this step, wujud jadual. Okay, refer to the table. Okay, so kamu boleh guna konsep satu tolak 0.7321. Okay, so saya ulang lagi sekali ya guys, macam mana baca jadual. Okay, so when you use 1 minus 0.7321, you will get 0.2679 or 0.268. Okay, so now you refer the table, lihat jadual. Okay, so 0.268. Okay, kita lihat. Okay guys, so I already find the closest value. So which one guys? Do I take 0.2709 or 0.2676? Mana satu? Untuk 0.268. Which one do I choose? May I know? Kita pilih yang mana? Antara dua ni. 2709 or 2676? Yes, always choose the higher value guys. Pilih nilai yang lebih tinggi. So you will choose 0.2709. Okay, kamu akan pilih nilai ni. Okay, so the score Z will be 0.61. Okay, so now your answer is 0.2679. Okay, 2679. Okay, so now how do I convert 0.2709 to 2679? Saya kena tolak berapa sekarang? What must I minus? Yes. Okay, you must minus 30. Okay, 0.2709 minus answer. You will minus 30. Okay, so you find the value. Okay, lihat nilai. Okay, so you go. Okay, you don't see 30 guys. Kamu tak nampak 30. But you see 29. Am I right? Yes. Okay, so means that you add number 9. At the third decimal place. Titik perpuluhan ketiga, kamu tambah 9. Okay? So, boleh lihat. Okay? Sama kan guys? Same right? So, this is how you read the table. Negative 0.619. Okay? Boleh dapat guys? Are you all clear? One or two? Satu atau dua? So, then kamu just selesaikan algebra lah untuk cari mean. Okay? Darab silang dan selesaikan. Okay, so now guys, may I ask you, why got negative sign here? Kenapa ada simbol negative guys, kat sini? What is the reason? Can anyone explain? Cuba terangkan. Mengapa ada negative kat situ? Ah, yang ni semua kamu kena faham. You must understand. Why must have a negative? Just now, yes. Okay, correct. Just now, kamu guna satu tolak pi. Am I right? Okay, so satu tolak pi, kamu akan tukar simbol ni. Betul? Okay, you will change the sign when you use 1 minus. Okay, so now guys, boleh tak kamu guna jadual untuk baca kebarang kalian bila simbol dia macam ni? Can you read the normal table when your symbol is less than? Yes or no? Very good. Ingat guys, selalu dalam bab ni simbol ketaksamaan kena lebih besar. It must be greater than. Okay, greater than, lebih besar. Lebih kecil tak boleh. Less than cannot. Okay, mengapa? So you refer over here guys. Can you see this? Boleh nampak kawasan belorek yang ni? Kawasan belorek ni ke kanan. Betul? Your shaded region is to the right. Means that setiap simbol ketaksamaan yang kamu ada ke kanan. Mestilah ke kanan. It must be to the right. Because the table is used when the shaded region is to the right. Okay, hanya boleh guna jadual bila kawasan belorek di sebelah kanan. Okay, can you guys understand? Boleh faham? So that's why kamu kena tukar simbol balik. Dari sini, tukar simbol balik. Okay, so sekarang guys, when you change the symbol, bila tukar simbol, kamu selalunya kena tambah negatif kepada skor Z. You must add a negative sign to the score Z. Okay? Can you guys get it? So you will get negative 14.5 plus mu over 4 bahagi 4. Okay, can guys? 1 or 2? 1 or 2? 1 ah. Okay, the rest? Yang lain? Tengah tidur ke? Are you all sleeping? Come on. 1 or 2? Okay, boleh ah. Okay, next question. Okay, soalan 8 guys. Number 8. Okay, so now they ask you to find mean and sigma. Okay, so now, bila kamu nak cari dua benda yang tak tahu, apa kaedah yang kamu guna? What method? When you are solving two unknown. Dua benda yang kamu tak tahu. Yes, always go back to simultaneous equation, guys. Pergi balik kepada persamaan linear serentak. Okay? So you must form two equation from this information. Kamu kena bentuk dua persamaan dari sini. Okay, so how? Same concept. Okay, kamu sekarang tak tahu mean, tak tahu sisian TY. You don't know both. Mean don't know, standard deviation don't know. So tak apa, letak saja simbol dia kat situ. Okay? So now guys, kamu tengok yang ni. Lebih besar kebarangkalian lebih kecil dari 0.5. So ada apa-apa kesilapan tak guys dalam info pertama ni? Is there anything we should change? Ada apa-apa benda yang kita kena ubah kat sini? Yes or no? Yes, nothing. Okay, tak ada apa-apa. Everything is correct already. Okay, but look at the second one guys. Lihat yang kedua. Ada apa-apa salah tak kat sini? Is there anything wrong? Yes. What is it? Apa yang salah guys? Very good. Always remember guys, the sign must be greater than. Okay, so when you switch the sign, tambah negative. So negative 30. Okay, you switch the sign, you must always add negative. So negative 30. Okay, are you clear? Probability, must we change anything guys? Adakah kita kena ubah apa-apa kat kebarang kalian? No need. Okay, because it's less than 0.5 tadi. Lebih kecil dari 0.5. Okay, so then kamu selesaikan macam biasa. Okay, solve as normal. Okay, so you can refer the table. Lihat jadual. What is greater than but probability greater than 0.5? Let me think and see. 1 minus lah. Okay. Okay, this question is a good question. Okay, guys, let's say lah. I have a question like this. Z greater than 0.4 equal to 0.6. Okay, bagi dia senang lah macam ni. Okay, so now guys, how many mistake are here? Berapa kesalahan yang kamu nampak guys? Cuba komen. Yes. Okay, there is one mistake guys. Ada satu kesalahan kat sini. Iaitu kebarang kalian guys. The probability is greater than 0.5. Kebarang kalian dia lebih besar dari 0.5. So yang ni pasti salah. So guys, macam mana nak bagi dia kurang dari 0.5? How to make it lesser than 0.5? May I know? Yes, 1 minus lah. Okay, kamu guna kaedah 1 tolak. That's all. So guys, when you use 1 minus, without tablet, very hard one. Tanpa tablet, sangat susah nak tulis. 1 minus probability. Wait. I will explain to you. Z. Okay guys, when you use 1 minus, switch the sign. Tukar simbol. Okay, so you switch it like this. Z score maintain. Dan jangan ubah apa-apa. Don't change anything over here. Okay, equal to 0.6. Okay, now guys. Kamu sekarang lihat yang ni salah. Betul? Okay, there is a mistake over here. Because the sign should be greater than. Okay, simbol dia kena lebih besar. Kalau kamu nak guna jadual. Okay, this one is the mistake now. Okay, so how to change it guys? Macam mana nak tukar dia? Okay, so you write probability Z get greater than, lebih besar. Then negative 0.4. So guys, do you see? When I switch the sign, bila saya tukar simbol, saya akan tambah negatif. So this is the answer you get now. Ini adalah jawapan dia. Boleh faham guys? Can you understand for the question you ask? So this is how we change it. Okay. Okay. Of course, this one is not the correct value lah, guys. Ini bukan nilai sebenar. Ini saja contoh saja saya bagi. Tak maksud dia betul. Okay, it doesn't mean it's correct one. It's just a random example. Okay, so just for to make you understand. Okay, all right. So for question 8, guys, you can form the two equation. Kamu boleh bentukkan dua persamaan. Okay, so these are the two equation that they form for you. Okay, so the table. Do I need to show you again, guys? Macam mana baca jadual tu? Tak perlu kan? It's the same concept only. Okay, so you understand lah how to get this answer and how to get this answer, -1.9. Okay, so you must know already. Okay, now guys, you have two equation. Kamu ada dua persamaan. So you just need to solve simultaneous. Okay, guys, may I know how many method you have to solve simultaneous? Berapa kaedah ada? May I know? Yes. Actually, we have three. Okay, kita ada tiga kaedah sebenarnya. The first method is called elimination, penghapusan. Second is substitution, penggantian. Third one you know is what dah, guys? Yang ketiga kamu tahu apa ke? Anyone? No. In AdMath, I mean. Dalam AdMath sahaja, bukan modern math campur. AdMath also got three method, tiga kaedah. Third one is called as graphical method, guys. Kaedah graph. Have you all heard of it? Means that you draw graph and then find, oh never hear. Got, ada kaedah lukis graph. Tapi jarang guna. Very rarely you use the third method. Okay, but third method pun ada. Okay, tapi kat sini kita akan pilih satu atau dua sahajalah. We choose the first two method. Okay, so kamu boleh pilih lah mana kaedah kamu suka antara kedua-dua ni. Just choose any one method. Okay, so your answer will look something like this. Are you all clear? Boleh dapat? Senang kan? Very straightforward, right? Okay, you just need to be careful with your algebra only. Optional. This one, right, guys? Over here. You asking this one, right? Do I need to draw this? Okay, this one is optional. Okay, bergantung pada kamu, guys. If you feel that you need it to understand better, kamu rasa kamu nak lukis untuk faham lebih baik, tak apa, lukis. Sebab lukisan tak ada markah. Kamu kena faham. Okay, this drawing over here has 0 mark. No mark at all. Tak ada markah. Sama ada kamu lukis betul atau salah, tak apa-apa. Apa-apa pun tak jadi. Nothing happen. Okay? The examiner won't see the graph one. Less, you mean less and lower than 0.5, is it? Do you mean that? Less and lesser than 0.5. Is that your question? You can modify also. Okay, let's say I give a value of 0.4. Okay, probability. Okay, so let's say I put probability Z less than 0.8. Okay, katakan ini soalan, guys. Guys, you must know, when I create this question, sometimes it's not valid, you know. Dia tak valid. So, kamu sebenarnya tak boleh selesaikan persamaan macam ni. But I'm just showing you the concept only. Okay, faham konsep sahaja. Okay, so guys, this one is correct. Nilai ni adalah betul. Okay, is the symbol correct, guys? Adakah simbol saya betul ke tak? Yes or no? Okay, not correct. Okay, so what you must do is you switch symbol. Okay, so probability Z greater than negative 0.8. Okay, so you will get something like this. Are you clear? So 0.4 you read from the table and then you convert to score Z. Okay, so of course here is not 0.8. Dia bukan 0.8, mungkin dia akan jadi 0.8 tolak mean bagi dengan sisian PRY, but divide by standard deviation. Okay? Of course, this one is not 0.8. Understand, guys? So, this is the concept only. Ini adalah konsep dia sahaja. Alright? One or two, guys? Satu atau dua? Are you clear on this? The rest? Yang lain? So, just change in. Yes, correct. That is the basic concept, guys. Change symbol, put negative. Okay, tukar symbol dan letak negative sahaja. Okay. Alright, so we go to the next question, guys. Okay, so this one. Okay, guys. we see this example, guys. Okay, so for this example, they want you to find the probability. Cari kebahagian kalian. Okay, so again, it's the same concept lah. Okay, so guys, can you all type out how does the symbol look like for question A? Macam mana soalan dia akan nampak? Cuba bagi saya jawapan dalam bentuk simbol. How will you write out the probability expression? Macam mana kamu tulis ungkapan kebahagian kalian tu? Yes, very good. Correct. Okay, guys, may I know? I ask you a good question. Wait, let me show it. Okay, guys, since you write like this, right? Kamu tulis macam ni. Less than X, less than 1.09. Okay, guys, this is the first answer. Okay, I got another answer here. Ada satu lagi jawapan sebenarnya. Okay, guys, may I know which answer is correct? Mana jawapan antara dua ni adalah betul? Cuba bagi tahu saya. Which one is the correct one? Untuk soalan A. For question A, guys. Which one is the correct one? Mana yang betul? Tell me. Anyone? Mana jawapan yang betul untuk kebangkalian saya? Okay, some more people, lagi orang. Which one is the correct answer, guys? Mana jawapan betul antara dua ni? Okay, so all of you say either left or right, right? Okay, semua kata sebelah kiri atau kanan. Okay, the answer is both. Kedua-dua pun betul, guys. The special a bit. Both also is correct, guys. You write like this, correct? You write like this also correct. Dua-dua pun betul. Guys, why do you think is it like this? Kenapa dua-dua betul? Cuba bagi sebab kat saya. Why both of it is correct? Saya saja tipu kamu kat sini. I try to trick you all actually. See whether you all really understand or not. Normal distribution. Kamu semua betul-betul faham ke tak? So what is the reason, guys? Both of it is the correct answer. Apa kamu boleh kata? Apa sebab dia? Mengapa dua-dua ni betul untuk soalan A? No, it's not antara. Bukan sebab perkataan antara. Try to think and see, guys. Sebab, yes, correct. Finally, guys, that is the correct answer. Because it doesn't matter, guys. Dalam tabaran normal, adakah simbol ni dengan simbol ni ada beza tak, guys, dalam tabaran normal? Is there any difference between these two symbol? Yes. Your probability is still the same. Kebangkalian kamu masih sama. So guys, you can write both of these answer. Kamu boleh tulis mana satu yang kamu suka. Anything. Alright? So, the most important thing in normal is the symbol itself. Whether greater than or less than. Yang ni sahaja ada perbezaan. Okay, there is difference between these two only. Okay? Alright. So now guys, you can solve already. Okay, so let me show you. Oh, wait Okay, so this one, guys, this one is actually your textbook question. Am I right? Ini adalah soalan buku teks. Sat let me find for you guys. Okay, so if you solve correctly, you should get, let me check and see. You should have, the answer is 0.9104. Okay? 0.9104. I no need to show the solving process, right, guys? Saya tak perlu terangkan kan macam mana nak buat A. Okay, dia sangat basic saja, very common way only. Okay, kalau kamu nak faham lebih bagus, kamu lihat graph lah. Okay, draw a normal graph. Okay, and then you can understand better how to solve. Okay, so something like this. Wah, draw in laptop so hard, you know. Normal graph. Okay guys, you understand lah. Kamu faham lah. Walaupun dia tak perfect. Okay, so let's say guys, nilai kat sini 1.02. Okay. And then the other one is 1.09. Okay, katakan kat sini 1.09. Okay, so now guys, kamu kena cari kawasan mana sebenarnya. What region must you find now, guys? May I know? Kawasan apa kena cari sekarang? Yes, the middle one, guys. You must find the middle region. Okay? So how to find the middle region? What is the concept you all use? Apa kaedah kamu guna? So you must find this one. So means that? Yes. Always use one minus, guys. Bila nampak soalan yang ada dua simbol, macam ni dan macam ni, okay, you see this kind of question, you always going to use one minus. Kamu akan selalu guna satu tolak. Alright? Do you guys get it? So always use that concept one. Selalu guna concept two. Okay? So then you just refer to the table. Okay? We lihat jadual sahaja. Okay? So guys, this one over here, you have x less than 1.02. Am I right? You will minus this. Kamu akan tolak ke barang kalian yang ni. So guys, for this one, can I read from the table? Boleh tak saya baca jadual? Bagi nilai ni secara terus? Very good, cannot. If you use one minus, there's the symbol, yes. When you use one minus, less than, must change to greater than. Okay, that one is only for the situation like this. Let me show you this one. For this type of question. Okay, can you see this question? This one. When you have only one inequality symbol, like this. Bila kamu ada satu simbol ketaksamaan saja, then you use one minus p x less than 0.69. You all see it, guys? Boleh nampak tak? Ah, kat sini baru kamu tukar simbol equal to 0.5178. Okay? Can get it? Boleh dapat. So this is how you switch the symbol. Ah, but for this question, soalan kat bawah yang ni, wait, this one. This one have two symbol. Am I right? Lihat kat sini. You have two inequality symbol. Okay, dua symbol ketaksamaan. So kat sini tak boleh guna concept tu. You cannot use that concept. Okay? So for this one, right guys? Untuk yang ni, okay, so how do I change, guys? Okay, actually can use the concept. Masih boleh guna. But kamu kena guna kepada satu kebahagiaan kalian sahaja. You might just use it on one probability, which is this one. Okay, so how do I change this, guys? Can you all type out for me? Macam mana saya boleh tukar yang ni? What will you get? The value part where you read all, I not concerned. I want to concern on this part only. How you change? Macam mana tukar? May I know? What will be your answer? Sebab yang ni simbol dia salah kan? The inequality sign is wrong. Yes, like that only lah. Okay, 1 minus px greater than 1.02. Okay, settle. Like that only. Okay, are you all clear? Boleh dapat, guys? So this is how you change the symbol. That's all. Okay? Can, guys? Boleh? So your answer, you should get 0.9104 if you solve correctly. Okay, over here, I didn't show the working. Saya tak masukkan jalan kira. Tapi boleh wujud buku teks. Okay, you can refer your textbook for the working. Okay, for 22A. Alright. So next one, guys. For question B, can you all tell me how does the symbol look like? Boleh bagi tahu saya macam mana simbol ketaksamaan nampak? How? Question B is tricky. Sedikit susah. Question B. So how should I write it? Type the whole equation for me. Bagi saya seluruh persamaan untuk soalan B. Come on, guys. Give me the answer. Bagi jawapan. Okay. Yes. Correct. Okay, so you just follow the sentence only, guys. Ikut ayat dia sahaja, sebulat-bulat. Okay, so you will have probability x greater than 1.08. Okay, guys, now, may I know the symbol in between. Simbol kat tengah-tengah kat sini darab atau tambah? Cuba bagi tahu saya. Do I need to times these two or plus both of these two? Okay, why plus? May I know why you say plus? Kenapa kena tambah? Very good. Guys, when you see the word or, means that must plus. Kamu semua belajar set kan? You all learn on the set. Am I right? Okay, all means it is union. Okay, yes. If plus, yes, correct. If done, kalau kamu nampak simbol done, if you see the word and, then you must times. Okay, it's something like that one, the concept. Okay, so this one again, same concept. You can refer the table. Okay, guys, may I know this one, this value over here, any problem? Ada apa-apa kesilapan dengan simbol ketaksamaan ni? Is there any problems in this symbol? Yes or no? Ada apa-apa masalah tak, guys? Yes, very good. Don't have, guys. Tak ada. This one? Ada apa-apa masalah tak? Is there any problem here? Yes. Okay, got. So what you must do is, you just change lah. Switch to negative 0.992. That's all. Okay, and then minus mean divide standard deviation. Concept sama. Okay, then you read the table. Baca jadual. Okay, are you all clear? So if you solve correctly, you should get the answer 0.0687. Okay, 0.0687. Okay, clear guys? Are you all okay with example 22? One or two? Satu atau dua? Okay, so this is the very standard type of question lah. Okay, sangat standard punya. Okay, so now we come to more of daily life. Okay, kamu boleh lihat sini guys, aplikasi, application question guys. Okay, so application question, don't worry, it's still the same concept, but they give you a situation. Mereka bagi situasi. Okay, so situasi apa kat sini guys? Menternak ayam, wearing a chicken. That is the situation. So whenever have situation in admats, automatically dia akan cakap kebat. Tak maksudnya dia akan susah. It doesn't mean it's hard. It's just because they give you a situation, daily life, they call it kebat. Mereka bagi tahu kebat sahaja. Okay? So don't be worried or scared when you see the word kebat. Okay? Alright. So this is the information guys. Okay, so now they ask you to find the number. Cari bilangan ayam yang berjisim antara dua-dua jisim ini. Okay, you must find the value of the number of chicken. Okay, so first guys, first step, kita kena cari apa dari sini? What must we find first? Yes, okay, you must find the probability guys. Dengan probability, baru kamu boleh tahu bilangan. Am I right? If you don't have probability, you don't know the number of chicken. That's the concept. Okay, so yes, macam ada orang type tadi. Okay, you follow exactly. So concept sama lah guys. Like what I showed you last question, exactly the same. Soalan dia berulang saja, cuma nilai dia berbeza. Okay, it's different value. Okay, so you can see the working. Tak ada working. Nevermind. So kamu boleh ujar buku teks lah guys. Untuk yang ni, just refer your textbook one. Okay, for you can find it on page 181. 181 muka buku teks. Okay, so kamu boleh lihatlah cara mereka selesaikan untuk soalan A. Okay, how they solve. Okay guys, if you solve correctly right, this one, your probability should get 0.2708. Ini adalah nilai kebangkalian. Yes, correct. Less than 0.5. That's all. That one only your mistake. Okay, so you just solve, you should get this answer. Okay, kamu akan dapat kebangkalian yang ni. Okay, now guys, you have the probability. How do I find the number of chicken? Macam mana cari bilangan ayam menggunakan nilai ni? May I know? Important concept. So what should I do now? Kena buat apa? Anyone? What should I do? Kamu ada kebangkalian, that's the probability. And then you have the total number of chicken. Jumlah ayam 1500. So how do you find the number of chicken now? Macam mana cari bilangan ayam? Anyone? What should I do? Think logic. Fikir secara logik saja kamu akan dapat jawapan. Just think logic only. Anyone? Come on. What should I do? How to find the number guys? Macam mana nak cari bilangan ayam? How? Think and see. Hello guys, can respond a bit? Boleh respond tak? So how do I find the number of chicken between this mess dalam lingkungan jisim ni? When I got total 1,500, my probability adalah nilai yang ni. So anyone? Macam mana guys? How? Yes, guys, you take the total times the probability, you get the number. Am I right? Kamu ambil jumlah ayam kali dengan kebarangkalian dia. So kamu akan dapat bilangan ayam dalam lingkungan jisim yang ni. You will get the number of chicken within this range. If you take the total chicken times the probability chicken within this range. Okay? How to know there is an error? Oh, okay. First step, you check this. First thing you always check is the probability value. It must be lower than 0.5. Then only you can read the table. Okay? Second, you check the symbol. It must be greater than for your X score. X greater than 18. Example, it must be greater than lebih besar. So these are the two main ones that you must check. Dua ni sahaja. Alright? Can? So something like this. Okay, and then of course you must know how to switch lah. Kamu kena tahu cara tukar. Okay, example, if the probability greater than 0.5, 1 minus, tukar simbol ketaksamaan. Macam saya bagi tahu tadi. Something like that. Okay, are you clear guys? One or two? I need more people to respond. Come on. One or two guys? One lah. Boleh lah. Okay, so next one. For question B, they tell you 10% guys. Okay, so may I know, 10% represent what? 10% ni mewakili apa guys? Selalu mereka akan uji kamu yang ni. You must know what does 10% represent. So what does it represent? Yes, the probability guys. Dia mewakili kebarangkalian sebenarnya. Okay, 0.1. Okay, so mereka bagi nilai lah M. Okay, so can anyone type for me? What is the probability expression for question B? Macam mana ungkapan kebarangkalian nampak untuk soalan B? Yang tu saja yang sangat penting dalam bab ni. Yang lain semua kalau kamu tak cuai pasti boleh buat sebab dia adalah asas sahaja. The most important thing is your first step, langkah pertama. Apa yang kamu tulis tu. So anyone? Boleh bagi jawapan? Yes, very good. Okay, so that is your probability expression. So probability X less than M, okay, you is equal to 0.1. Sama dengan 0.1. Okay? Can guys? So now you refer guys. Apa yang silap kat sini? Dalam persamaan ni. What is the mistake? Can you all tell me? So what can you see is wrong here? Apa nampak salah dalam ketaksamaan ni? Yes. Okay, you're less than guys. Simbol ni salah. So kena tukar lebih besar, tambah negatif. Negatif M. Okay? So this is the process. Okay? Boleh guys? Senang kan? Very easy, right? Lepas tu rujuk jadual sahaja. Okay? Cari skor Z untuk kebarangkalian 0.1. Okay? Find the Z score. Okay, banyak kali dah ulang dah. Okay, so kamu hanya aplikasikan konsep sama untuk nombor berbeza sahaja. Okay, so macam tu lah. Okay, so if you solve, you should get the answer 0.8157. Okay, untuk yang ni you should get 0.8157. Okay, can get it? So ini adalah jawapan dia. Okay guys, may I know, do I need to round off? Adakah saya kena bundakan nilai ni? Yes or no? Ataupun kekal macam tu sahaja? What do you all think? Bundakan atau kekal? Do I round off or maintain? Anyone? Cuba jawab. Do I round off this number or I maintain the number? Come on guys, perlu bundarkan ke tak? Do I need to round off this number? This one, 0.8157. Perlu tak saya bundarkan? Yes, tak perlu. Okay, no need. Okay, bila saya kena bundarkan jawapan dalam kebarang kalian ni? Siapa tahu? When do I need to know when to round off the value in this chapter? What situation? Apa jenis soalan saya perlu round off? Siapa boleh bagi tahu? Satu jenis soalan saja, guys. One type of question only. You need to round off. So anyone? No, no, no. I mean, when they asking like this, cari nilai M, macam tu. Yes, guys. Bilangan, guys. Whenever they ask you on number, baru kamu kena bundarkan. When they talk about bilangan, then only you round off. Okay? Boleh, guys? So this is the probability value. How to solve this? Mengapa kamu tanya yang tu? Yang tu sama kan dengan apa yang kita belajar? Mungkin yang tu kamu boleh PM saya. Nanti saya cuba solve untuk kamu. Okay, sebab sekarang saya nak cover soalan lain. Okay, boleh PM saya soalan tu. Nanti saya lihat. Alright, so jangan lupa nanti. Okay guys, we come to the next exercise. Okay. Okay guys, saya tanya kamu lah lebih senang. Kita takkan solve yang susah-susah punya. I mean secara mendalam lah. Kita tak selesaikan secara mendalam. Okay, so now guys, question one. So, mereka suruh cari score X. Okay, find your X score. Okay, menggunakan informasi yang ni, based on these two information. Okay, so, what's the formula guys? May I know? Untuk 1A, apa rumus kita guna? What is the formula we are going to use? May I know? A dan B juga, both of this question. What is the formula? Apa rumus dia? Yang ni kamu kena ingat lah. What is the formula we are using here? Anyone? Apa rumus dia guys? Cepat. What is the formula we are using? Jangan segan tahu untuk jawab. Jawab saja. When you answer, you improve. Yes, guys. Okay, Z equal to X minus mean bahagi sigma. Itu saja. Okay, so you use this formula for two question. A and also B. Okay, cari unknown dia. Cari yang X dan score Z. Okay, then kamu dapat jawapan. Ganti semua nilai saja. Just substitute all the informations. Okay, so you will get something like this. Jawapan dia macam ni. Okay, sangat senang saja. Very simple. Okay, next one. Soalan yang kedua. They ask you to find the K value. Cari nilai K. Alright. Okay, so mereka bagi tahu. Okay, now guys. May I know? Luas rantau berlorek tu mewakili apa? What does your area of shaded region represent in the normal graph? Dia mewakili kuantiti apa sebenarnya? Luas rantau berlorek. So anyone? Yes. Okay, percentage guys. Kebarang kalian. Okay, so you will get 0.245. Okay, 0.245 adalah kebarang kalian kamu. Your probability. Okay, so now you must find your K value. So guys, can you all type out for me what is your probability expression? Apa taburan kebarang kalian kamu? Kamu punya rumus. Apa dia? Cuba type berdasarkan soalan ni. Anyone? Apa rumus dia? How does it look like? Cuba type kat saya. Macam mana ungkapan kebarang kalian tu nampak? How does the probability expression look for this one? Untuk kawasan berlorek yang ni. Anyone? Cepat. What is your expression guys? 0.245 adalah yang ni. Anyone? Cuba type. Cepat. What's your answer guys? Probability expression. Anyone? Apa nilai? Sorry, apa ungkapan dia, guys? What is the expression for this area? Coba type. Kalau yang tu kamu tahu, kamu dah boleh solve. You can solve the question, Adi. Oh, kamu dah terlebih kot. Uni. Kamu kena tulis macam ni. Tak dah. K. Lepas tu. Less than X. Less than 25.4. Boleh faham tak, guys? Kamu kena tulis macam ni. Okay, saat saya tulis lebih baik kat sini. K less than X, less than 25.4. Boleh faham? Ini adalah ungkapan dia. Sebab kawasan berlorek dia adalah kat tengah-tengah. Okay, the probability is in between. Okay, kebangkalian dia kat tengah-tengah kat sini. Can you guys understand? Boleh faham? Yes or no? Cuba komen, guys, one or two. So kamu hanya perlu selesaikanlah yang ni untuk K. Sama sahaja, konsep sama. Okay? So kamu guna satu tolak, kebangkalian lebih besar dari 25.4. Tolak, kebangkalian lebih kecil dari K sama dengan nilai ni. Okay, so then kamu modify ikut ciri-ciri tadi yang saya bagi tahu. Modify based on the formula. Okay, so kamu akan dapat jawapan macam ni. Okay, you will get something like this. Okay, so kamu selesaikan untuk nilai K sahaja. Just solve for your K value. Okay, are you clear, guys? Untuk soalan dua, should be okay, right? Okay, so kita lihat lagi. Apa lagi jenis soalan dia suka tanya. Okay, so number three, guys. Okay, so for this one, mereka bagi tahu seorang murid dipilih secara rawak. Okay, you choose a student randomly. So they want you to find the height. Okay, guys, sekurang-kurangnya, at least, what is the symbol, guys? Apa simbol ketaksaman untuk yang ni? You must be clever to identify the symbol. Kena bijak tengok simbol ketaksaman. So what is the symbol? Sekurang-kurangnya. Eh, tak. Sekurang-kurangnya, guys, at least. Sepatutnya dia lebih besar atau sama dengan. Selalu ingat, guys. Jangan confuse nampak perkataan kurang, kamu kata lebih kurang atau sama dengan. Salah. Itu adalah selebih-lebihnya. Selebih-lebihnya guna simbol ni. Yes. Okay. For at most, you use this symbol. At least, you use this symbol. Can? So, something like that. Okay. So, you will get. Kamu selesaikan sajalah untuk kebangkalian dia. Okay. So, macam mana, guys? First step. Convert X score to Z score. Okay. Kamu tukar dari score X ke score Z. Okay. Guna rumus saja. Okay. Sekarang. Ah. Screen stuck lah, guys. Saya nampak tak stuck pun. Yang lain boleh cuba lihat tak? Adakah screen saya tak gerak? Gerak kan? It's moving, right? My screen. The rest, guys. Can you comment? Gerak. Oh, okay, mungkin masalah kamu lah internet code. It's still in the answer scheme. Eh? I think your side only. The rest, sekarang boleh nampak tak answer scheme ni, soalan tiga? Sebab saya nampak, I can see. Okay, boleh. I think kamu kena leave dan join balik so that it come better. Okay, guys? So you just need to solve like this. Okay, PX greater than or equal to 140. Okay, so then you solve only. Selesaikan macam biasa. Okay, then you will get the answer. Dapat jawapan. Alright? Kat sini, guys. Kena tukar apa? What do I need to change over here? May I know? Kena tukar apa, guys? Apa saya kena tukar, guys, kat sini? Adakah saya boleh baca nilai ni dari jadual tak, guys? Negative 0.5 skor Z. Tak boleh, kan? I cannot read this from the table. Hanya skor Z yang positif saja saya boleh baca dari jadual. I can only read a positive Z score from the table. So maksudnya, what must I do, guys? I must switch to less than 0.5. Bila tukar simbol negatif jadi positif. Okay, you change the symbol, you will come from negative 0.5 to positive 0.5. Okay, tapi sana, yes. Okay, so sekarang kamu boleh baca jadual. You can read the table already. Okay, sebab sekarang dia macam ni. Okay, something like this. Okay guys, boleh? One or two? So kamu akan dapat jawapan ni terus dari jadual. Refer to the table. Okay? Alright, next one. Soalan 3B. Mereka bagi tahu cari bilangan murid. Find the number of student. Okay guys, can you all tell me? Tidak lebih daripada. Not more than. What is the symbol guys? Inequality symbol. Apa simbol ketaksaman dia? Cuba komen. Tidak lebih daripada. Lebih kecil dan sama. Yes, kurang dan sama. Correct. Okay? Guys. Okay, can. Sebab normal, dia tak kisahlah. Okay? Yang ni ataupun yang ni, dua-dua betul. Both also correct. No worries. Okay? Kamu boleh tulis mana-mana yang kamu nak. Okay? So, first step, macam biasa, convert Z score. Convert X score to Z score. Score X ke score Z. Okay, so kamu akan dapat macam ni. You will get something like this. Okay, so guys, kamu lihat. Yang ni ada apa-apa masalah tak guys? There is no problem, right? Tak ada apa-apa masalah dengan ungkapan yang ni. Okay, because the symbol. Sat, ada masalah. Okay, symbol dia guys. The symbol must be to the right. Okay, selalu ingat kena ke kanan. Okay, so you must switch guys. Kena tukar simbol. Okay, tapi bila kamu tukar simbol dapat negatif pula. Tak boleh. Okay, cannot like this. So how guys? Kalau tak boleh macam ni, kita akan guna kaedah satu tolak guys. One minus. Sebab satu tolak dia takkan ubah simbol skor Z. Dia hanya ubah simbol ketaksamaan saja. It just change the inequality symbol. But not negative or positive skor Z. Can you all see? So kamu kena buat yang ni sahaja. Okay? Boleh dapat guys? Can you all see? And then sebab dia suruh cari bilangan murid, number of students. So kamu ambil kebahagian kalian kali dengan jumlah. The total number of students. Then you get the answer. Dapat jawapan. Okay? One or two guys? Satu atau dua? Can you get it? Comment. One lah. Okay, semangat lah guys. Nak habis dah ni. Okay, question number four. Okay, so question number four. Okay, so mereka suruh cari bilangan murid lagi sekali. Okay, so guys, cuba bagi tahu saya 70 markah dan ke atas. Apa simbol ketaksamaan dia? 70 marks and above. What will be your inequality symbol? Cuba komen. Yes, more equal or more also can lah. Okay, kamu boleh pilih lah. Sama ada yang ni ataupun yang ni. Dua-dua pun boleh because it's normal. Okay, both also can. Alright, so now you have the mean, CCMPRY, konsep biasa lagi sekali guys. Okay, you use the exact same concept. Okay, so kamu dapat yang ni. Okay guys, nilai ni boleh baca terus dari jadual. You can read directly from the table because simbol ketaksamaan betul ke kanan, your inequality sign to the right dan skor Z kamu adalah positif. Positif skor Z. So direct refer table. Okay, lepas tu kali jumlah dapat bilangan. Okay, times the total you will get the number of people. Okay, so this one is for 4A. Okay, lepas tu 4B. For question 4B, mereka kata 60% guys. Okay guys, so may I know 60%, what does it represent? Dia mewakili apa? 60% ni, sekali lagi, always remember guys, probability, kebahagiaan kalian, correct. Okay, so now, they ask you markah minimum untuk lulus guys. So can you all tell me the probability expression, ungkapan kebahagiaan kalian. Markah minimum untuk lulus. Macam mana kamu tulis? Yes, very good guys. Because lulus, kamu kena besar dan besar daripada atau sama dengan. More than or equal to. So kamu bubuh X. Okay, maka lulus kamu tak tahu. So kamu bagi simbol sajalah. just give a symbol M. Kamu katakan M tu adalah markah minimum untuk lulus. M is the minimum mark to pass. Okay, so you make this assumption over here. Lepas tu cari nilai M. So bila dapat nilai M, kamu dah selesaikan soalan. Itu maksud dia. Okay, you must find the M value. Okay, so kamu akan dapat macam ni. You will get something like this. Okay, so again, check balik. Inequality sign, correct, betul. Tapi kebangkalian lebih besar, guys. Tak boleh. Okay, so 1 minus, 1 tolak. Okay, 1 tolak, simbol akan tukar. Okay, dari lebih besar jadi lebih kecil. Okay, M tolak 50 sama dengan 0.6. Okay, so lepas tu, kamu buat apa, guys? Kamu kena tukar balik. MMX, kamu kena tukar balik simbol. Because our shaded region is to the right. Okay, kawasan berlawai kita ke sebelah kanan. So you will tambah negatif. Okay, add negative sign. Okay, sebenarnya negatif kat sini, guys. Dari jadual, kamu baca selalu dia akan positif. You always read from the table, you will get positive answer. So mengapa negatif tiba-tiba? Sebab originally ada negatif di sebelah kiri. Kamu akan pindah kanan. That's why kamu nampak mereka terus tulis negatif di sebelah kanan. Can you see, guys? Boleh lihat tak? Mereka skip satu langkah sebenarnya. They skip a step. Okay, tapi kamu boleh tulis step 2 untuk lebih faham. Okay, guys? One or two, guys, for question B. Soalan B boleh faham? Okay, make sure kamu bundarkan lah sebab markah dia kena nombor bulat. Okay, mark must be a whole number, nombor bulat. So make sure kamu bundarkan. Jangan tinggal yang ni. Don't leave your answer this one. Salah. Okay? So, yeah. This is for question number 4. Okay? Can continue, guys? Boleh pergi, ya? Okay, next one. Soalan nombor 5. Okay, kita expose lah. Dedahkan dengan lebih banyak soalan. Okay, so for question 5. Mereka suruh cari. Okay, guys. Kamu lihat yang ni saja, kamu tahu dah, guys. When you see this, kena guna konsep apa? What concept must I use? Bila nampak dua unknown, two variable that I don't know, dua pemboleh ubah tak tahu. So guna konsep apa? What is the name of the concept? Yes, persamaan serentak, guys. Simultaneous equation, correct. Okay, so kamu kena bentukkan persamaan. Okay, so again, the percentage will represent the probability. Okay, peratusan tu mewakili kebarangkalian. Okay, lepas tu kamu bentuk dia daripada pernyataan. Just form the inequality symbol. Okay, so first one, kamu akan dapat yang ni. Okay, so score X, tukar score Z. Okay, change the score X to score Z. Standardize. Okay, so yang ni, nilai dia boleh baca. Yang ni pun simbol dia betul. So this equation totally is correct. Semuanya betul. So terus baca dari jadual. 0.1, baca score Z. Okay? Dan selesaikan saja bentuk satu persamaan, form one equation. Okay, now, yang ni kebangkalian betul tapi simbol salah. So, tukar simbol, tambah negatif. Okay, so negatif ni sebenarnya macam ni sekarang. Okay, so bila kamu pindah simbol negatif, negatif akan berada di sebelah kanan pula. Macam ni. Okay, the negative sign you shift to the right hand side. Okay, then kamu dapat persamaan kedua. Selesaikan secara serentak. Solve simultaneous. Okay? Boleh, guys? Senang, kan? So, ini adalah soalan 5. Question 5. Okay, suka tanya macam ni dalam exam. Okay? Alright. Question 6 is kebat. Soalan 6 ni kebat sebenarnya. Tapi tak sangat susah lah. Okay, so mean sisian piawai sudah diberi. Okay. So, guys, you see the situation. If it's between this mass, kalau di antara julat ni, dia akan diekspor. Kalau lebih kurang, if it's less than that, it will be sold at the local market. Okay, dia dijual di pasar tempatan. Okay, so now, they ask you kebangkalian, probability, export. So guys, dia merujuk yang pertama, info pertama atau kedua? Saya nak tahu. Today refer to the first sentence or second sentence. Sekarang dia nak export. Yes, first sentence lah. So, kamu buat sahaja simbol ketaksamaan dia. Macam biasa. Okay, exactly the same. Okay, so over here, guna konsep 1 minus PZ greater than 42 over 24. Yang ni tak ada masalah, no problem. Direct refer table. Yang kedua, PZ lebih kecil. Okay, so lebih kecil, simbol salah, score Z pun salah. Your Z score also wrong because negative. Score Z hanya boleh positif. So yang ni, kamu tukar sahajalah simbol ketaksaman. So bila tukar simbol, change the symbol, hilang negatif. Tak ada negatif dah. Okay, so yang ni adalah yang betul. This is the correct one. Do you all understand? So yang ni, semua ni rujuk jadual sahaja. Just refer table dan selesaikan. So kamu akan dapat nilai ni. You will get this answer. Boleh guys? One or two? Satu atau dua? Untuk soalan A. Senang kan guys? Bab ni sangat standard. Proses dia berulang sahaja. Okay, it's the same thing. Okay, next one. Untuk B pula, dia suruh cari bilangan betik yang akan dijual di pasar tempatan. Okay, so this one, kamu guna yang mana guys? Pertama atau kedua? Info mana? Which information you all will use? Yes, yang kedua lah. Sebab dia suruh, oh, kat sini ada trick. Dia suruh tak export dan tak jual juga. Okay, so yang ni kamu kena cari compliment lah. Okay, compliment of the set. Macam simbol pelengkap. Okay, so mereka nak dua-dua pun pelengkap. Tak nak dua-dua. So macam mana? Okay, so kamu boleh guna konsep yang ni. Okay. So sebenarnya mereka cari dulu yang ni. Okay, you find this one first. You find the probability that it will be sold at the local market. Kamu cari kebangkalian dia dijual di pasar tempatan. So kamu dapat nilai ni dulu. Okay, lepas tu kamu akan ambil satu tolak kebangkalian dia dijual di luar negara, tolak kebangkalian dijual di pasar tempatan. So bila kamu buat yang ni, kebangkalian ni mewakili dia tak diekspor dan juga tak dijual di pasar tempatan. Boleh faham tak guys? Okay, when you take one minus these two answer, it show that you don't export and also you don't sell at local market. Okay, sebab because both of these represent they sell and also they export. Can you understand guys? So one minus lah. Always use one minus for complement untuk simbol pelengkap tu. Okay, dalam operasi set satu tolak selalunya. Okay, and then they ask you number. Mereka suruh cari bilangan. So kali dengan jumlah yang diberi kat sini. Times the total. 2,500. Okay? Boleh guys? One or two? Faham yang ni? Boleh kan? Okay, so we come to the last part guys. Yang terakhir dah. Okay, yang ni pendek saja, very short. Okay guys, so first question. They say that the probability is 0.3415. Okay, kebangkalian yang ni is this one. Okay, so they ask you find the value of K. Cari nilai K. Okay guys, can you tell me what is the probability expression over here? Apa ungkapan kebangkalian untuk soalan satu? What will be your expression? Anyone? Apa simbol kebangkalian dia untuk kawasan berlorek? What will be your expression? Guys, bila saya tanya berulang jangan bosan ah. Sebab bila kamu repeat benda sama, kamu memang akan faham sampai bila-bila. When you repeat the same thing, you will understand one forever. Dia takkan lupa. That's why saya ulang konsep sama. So that dia melekat pada minda kamu. It will stay in your mind. So anyone, can you tell what does this probability expression look like? Yes, correct. Kosong. Hajar, kamu kena include kosong juga. Okay, so dia akan nampak macam ni. It will look like this. Okay, sebab dia di antara dua-dua nilai, is in between. Okay, so kamu kena tulis macam ni. Okay, dan selesaikan sahaja untuk nilai K. Okay, so kosong, probability Z lebih besar dari kosong, selalunya 0.5. Okay, because it's half of the graph, setengah dari graph taburan normal. So 0.5. Okay, and then yang ni kamu kena lihatlah. Okay, so simbol ketaksamaan salah is wrong. Tapi kebahagiaan kalian betul, less than 0.5. So this one correct, this one wrong. So apa kamu buat guys? Tukar simbol negatif K sama dengan kebahagiaan kalian yang ni. So yang ni kamu baca jadual normal. Refer the normal table. Lepas tu tambah simbol negatif kat skor Z yang didapat. Sebab kat sini kamu kena ingat adalah negatif K. So kamu nak cari K. You want to find the K value, not the negative K. Okay, so that's why you shift the negative sign here. Okay, clear guys? So this is question number one, soalan satu. Okay, next one, soalan dua. They ask you to find the Z score. Okay, sama sajalah guys. Z equal to X minus mean over standard deviation. Okay, so kamu akan guna simbol ni. Rumus ni. You will use this formula. Okay, and then you find your Z value. Cari nilai Z. Okay, yang tu sangat direct. Okay, next one. Soalan B. They ask you to find probability. Kebahagiaan kalian yang ni. Okay, so again, same step lah guys. Convert X score to Z score. Tukar dari score X ke score Z. Okay, so kamu akan dapat macam ni. Okay, then what's the concept guys? Kamu akan guna satu tolak. Selalunya nampak macam ni, format yang ni. You see this format, always 1 minus. Okay, 1 minus probability Z lebih besar dari 1.5 over 2 tolak probability Z less than negative 0.5. Okay, so less than negative 0.5, tukar simbol jadi macam ni. Supaya kamu boleh baca dari jadual. You can read from the table. Okay, so kamu akan dapat jawapan yang ni. Senang tak guys? Komen kat saya sekarang. Senang tak? Easy right? Sangat standard. Okay, always like that only. Okay, so next one. Soalan yang ketiga. Okay, so mereka suruh cari yang ni. PZ less than M. Okay, so kamu selesaikan yang ni lah. Same step. Okay, kamu buat macam biasa. Okay, so kamu kena cari yang ni dulu dari jadual. Find the value from the table. Okay, lepas tu always 1 minus. Sebab kamu nampak yang ni. 1 minus nilai ni. And then minus kebahagiaan kalian antara rantau. Okay, between the region. Okay, so mereka dah bagi tahu nilai ni yang berlorek 0.5124. Okay, so kamu tolak yang ni, tolak yang ni. Okay, you minus all of this. Kamu akan dapat jawapan untuk yang ni, yang kecil ni, yang putih. Okay, the white one. So your answer you will get 0.1244. Okay, one or two guys, satu atau dua. Cuba respon, jangan tertidur pula. Masih satu ah. Okay, still faham. Okay, very good. Next one. Soalan empat, nak habis dah. Okay, so they tell you find the probability that the mass is between 2.9 and 3.3. Antara dua jisim ni. Okay, samalah lagi sekali. Okay, so dapat macam ni. Lepas tu, guna konsep sama. Use exact same concept, get the answer. Dapat jawapan. Okay? Tak perlu terangkan kan guys, yang ni. You all understand right? How to solve like this. Am I right? Anyone here don't understand? Semua faham dah kan? Okay, you all I think more than understand already. Okay, so you just take 1 minus PZ greater than 2 over 3 minus PZ less than 2 over 3. Today only my writing become not good guys. Sebab saya guna laptop. Lain kali, lain kelas semua saya guna tablet. Tapi hari ni tak sempat nak charge tablet dia. Tapi tak apalah, satu kali saja. Okay, so this will be your expression. Okay, so you just write like this. Okay, yang ni pastikan tukar. You must change it. So probability Z greater than 2 over 3. Change sign, negative become positive. Baca dari jadual. Read the table. Okay, so you will get this answer. Okay, next one. 4B. Okay, so for question 4B, 25%, nampak persen, probability kebahagiaan kalian. Underweight. Okay, maximum mass guys. May I know maximum mass? Apa simbol ketaksamaan? Jisim maximum. What will be? Yes. Betul lah. Lebih kurang atau sama dengan M lah. Kamu bagi simbol. Let the maximum mass be M. Okay, GC maximum adalah M. So, kamu selesaikan untuk M. Okay, so macam ni. Okay, yang ni mereka tulis lebih kurang sama saja, still the same. Okay, so okay, yang ni kamu check. Okay, yang ni betul, yang ni salah. This one wrong. So tukar simbol, tambah negatif. So negatif yang ni kamu akan pindah ke sebelah kanan. You shift it to the right to your Z score. Okay, you read the probability and Z score from the table. Okay, and then algebra sajalah. Okay, just solve by using algebra. Okay, so now second last question. Okay, soalan lima. Mr. Lim wearing fish. Okay, so they say probability mass less than 600, 0.0012. So kamu kena cari nilai P. Okay, so same concept lah guys. Exactly the same. Okay, so P adalah sisihan piawai, standard deviation. Okay, so you don't know, kamu bagi dia unknown. Okay, so check again. Betul? Salah. So kamu kena switch sign negative. Okay, nampak guys? Negative ni pindah ke kanan, ke score Z. You shift it to your Z score. Okay, yang ni asal dia sudah ada negative. Okay, originally this one got negative tadi. Because nilai ni adalah negative 50 tolak P. Betul? So kamu tulis nilai dia sahaja. Just write the value. The negative sign, after you switch the inequality sign, you shift it to the right over here, to the Z score. Okay, then you will get the answer. Okay, selesaikan sahaja. Okay, second last. Question 5B. Okay, so they suruh cari number of fish, bilangan ikan. Okay, so again, between maksudnya simbol dia macam ni. Okay, antara dua di sini. Okay, so again, same concept. Dapat yang ni macam saya terangkan tadi. 1 minus PZ greater than nilai ni tolak PZ lebih kecil dari nilai ni. Okay, refer jadual. Okay, then kamu dapat simbol ni. Okay guys, kat sini berbeza sikit. Mengapa dia bahagi guys? Siapa tahu? Why I must divide over here? Anyone know? Kenapa kat sini saya bahagi? Bukan darab yang ni. Over here. Based on the question. Mereka bagi tahu 350 ikan ada jisim dalam lingkungan ni. So sekarang dia suruh cari bilangan ikan dalam kolam. Find the number of fish in the pond. So why divide? Kenapa bahagi? Bukan darab. So this one you must be careful. Kena hati-hati. Sekarang mereka suruh cari total. Betul guys? The question is to find the total fish. Jumlah ikan. Tadi soalan sebelum-belum ni darab kan? Sebab dia suruh cari bilangan ikan dalam lingkungan ni. In this range. Tapi sekarang soalan dah bagi info ni. So guys, kamu kena reverse lah proses dia. So guys, darab apa yang bertentangan dengan darab guys? Cuba bagi tahu saya. What is the opposite of times? Divide right? Bahagilah. So that's why jawapan dia bahagi dua-dua nilai ni. You divide. Okay, then kamu dapat jawapan dia. You get the answer. Okay? And then mesti nombor bulat lah guys. Jangan bagi tahu saya ada 1007.75 ikan lah. Tak ada ikan macam tu lah. 0.75 ikan. Tak wujud di dunia ni. Okay, you must have a whole number for number of fish. Don't give your answer 1007.75. Something like that. Cannot. Okay, round off. Bundakan. Okay, last question guys. Yang terakhir. Okay, so mean, standard deviation, sisihan piawai. Okay. Guys, this value, nilai ni. Number of workers in the factory. This is the total. Ini adalah jumlah guys. And now they ask you to find number of worker more than 75. Yang ni adalah lingkungan range. So maksudnya kita akan guna konsep darab kat akhir-akhir. Okay, we will use the concept of times. Okay, so again, same concept. Kat sini score Z positive, symbol betul. Okay, your inequality sign is correct, positive Z score, direct refer table, cari nilai. Okay, then dapat jawapan. Okay, and then question B, cari nilai P. Okay, so guys, P percent maksudnya nak cari kebarangkalian. Am I right? Find the probability less than 85. Lebih kurang dari 85. Okay, so kat sini tukar ke score Z dulu. Change to Z score. And then yang ni salah. Okay, the symbol is wrong. So kamu guna satu tolak untuk tukar simbol kepada lebih besar 85. Okay, so then refer table, tengok jadual, dapat nilai ni and then find the answer. Ah, yes, correct. So guys, mereka tanya dalam peratus. So jangan tinggal jawapan kat sini. Don't leave your answer in probability. Okay, because question say P percent, P peratus. So kamu kena darab jawapan kebang kalian tu dengan 100% untuk tukar ke peratus, 63.06%. Okay, so you guys understand? Boleh faham? All of you over here. So we complete tadi lah chapter 5. Kita dah habis secara rasmi. Okay, semua soalan dalam bab 5 dari buku teks. Okay, are you guys clear? All of you boleh dapat lesson hari ini? Can understand? Boleh tak guys? Can ah? Bagus ah? Boleh faham ah? Okay, baguslah kalau faham. If you understand means very good. Okay, so